Hello guys! So, in one of my videos in which I made a comparison between the three game engines, Unity, Godot and Unreal, I talked a little bit about visual scripting. You can find the video up here by the way, and you'll find it in description box also. So, in this video I got a question that says, hey, I'm bad at programming, can I make an advanced game all with visual scripting? So, in this video we'll talk about that. And before starting, I will make it easy on you. And I will tell you that yes, you can make a game with visual scripts only. People made it, and you definitely could do it. But stay with me till the end of this video, because there's some good information that you should know about this topic. If we didn't meet yet, my name is Walid from Spectro Games and I'm an indie games developer. So in this video we have 5 big titles that we will talk about to get to our goal. First, the exact definition of visual scripting. After it, we will talk about visual scripting in Unity, Godot and Unreal. Then we will answer our big question. After that, we will take a quick look at some amazing games made with visual scripting. And last but not least, I will talk about my point of view in this subject. So, let's get started. So if we check Google, we find that visual scripting is a graphical way to manipulate objects and behaviors without handwriting. The logic is built by connecting visual notes together, empowering artists, designers and programmers to create gameplay and interactive systems in a simple way. So instead of writing code by hand that takes a lot of time for most of people, and trying to remember logic lines, commands and so many orders, you just use some logic blocks. The ones you see now to make logic between those blocks in your desired way to achieve your desired goal. Those blocks are called nodes. Visual scripting had a big problem when it just appeared. This problem was that people couldn't organize their logic page that contained a lot of nodes, which made the process of making games using it so much difficult. But they worked hard to solve this problem. Now they have something called a unit and a super unit. They have the same effects, or I should say rule of functions and method in normal scripting. You can imagine those units and super units like some block that contains a certain amount of nodes that can do a certain job or effect on the game. This block can be collapsed so you don't get lost in a big amount of nodes, and these units do the same thing that all those nodes does together. Visual scripting is also available in many other industries, not just game development. You can also find it in some advanced programs that uses programming as a base. What you should know also about visual scripting is that designers and especially people who make 3D models work with a material system that allows them to create effects or materials using nodes and stuff like this, so it might be easier to learn for them. So first, in Unity, there's 2 tools you can use for visual scripting. First one is PlayMaker and second one is Bolt. Both of them are advanced and they will allow you to make whatever logic you want. The only difference is that PlayMaker costs $65 and Bolt is totally free. So you should definitely go with Bolt. You know, it's free and you will do whatever you want with it. Plus Bolt is a Unity release, so they are upgrading it whenever they upgrade Unity to a newer version. That also means that it's totally free and compatible with Unity. You can start using it by installing it directly from Unity Asset Store. The Blueprint Visual Scripting is the system that's being used in Unreal Engine for visual scripting. This system is completely free and already installed in Unreal. You just search for the Blueprint Visual Scripting in the edit bar, tweak the settings and start working with it. You can check the link in the description that's gonna lead you to Unreal documents about visual scripting. Godot Engine also has a visual scripting tool being used to create logic. It's completely free and pre-installed with the engine, but I believe that it has some weaknesses. I already tried it and found that it's not easy as others. It needs a little bit of programming skills, so you can start working with it. I will link you to Godot's documents about this subject, you will find the link in the description box. Yes, you can make advanced games using only visual scripting. Think about it, it's the same thing as programming. I mean, instead of making a script and writing logic, you create a visual scripting script and drag drop your nodes. Usually, as normal programmers, we tend to make some small scripts, about 300 lines, because we want to organize our scripts. Every script has a certain functionality to achieve, and you can achieve the same script with visual scripting easily. And do the same. Each script handles a certain functionality, and you won't get lost in a lot of nodes and units, because as I said, you can organize it as well. But the problem is that when people hear all those informations about visual scripting, they think that it's too easy. You are just gonna open the script, start working, and you will finish it easily. It doesn't work like that. You will have to think about how to implement logic, how to structure your desired scripts, how to do the math, and a lot of stuff. The only difference is that you don't need to remember those lines of code. Now, you have a node that does what a line do. For example, an absolute value in both ways. In programming, you write mathf.abs means absolute value, and you open parentheses and you put your variable inside the parentheses. In visual scripting, you drag an absolute value node, you write your variable in the case, and it will give you the output of the node. We will see in the next section some amazing games made only with visual scripting. So, there's a lot of good games made using visual scripting, but in this video I'm gonna talk about one of them. The one I think it's truly amazing. It has an appealing graphics, amazing story, insane artworks, and good music and sound effects. It's really amazing. The one you are seeing now on the screen, it's called The First Tree, developed and published by David Weil in 2017. This game is made by Unity Engine using PlayMaker tool for visual scripting. At that time, Bolt wasn't released yet in Unity. So David struggled a lot in scripting because he couldn't remember all those orders and structures in normal scripting. So he decided to go with visual scripting. And in the end, he finished an amazing game. I'm gonna link you to a GDC video where he was talking about how he made that game and how the process was. You will get a lot of information from him. You should watch the conference. Link will be in the description box. So, in my point of view, I don't think there's a big difference between normal scripting and visual one. I tried both, but I prefer handwriting, because visual scripting has some limitations in its work. So, if you can program normally, you better do so. If you can't, use visual scripting. It's gonna help you a lot. And remember, everything is possible. You just need to believe in yourself. This is the end of this video, guys. I hope that it was helpful for you. If you made it till the end, I appreciate you. If you like it, give it a thumbs up, smash subscribe and answer notifications bell, because I drop cool videos every week and you don't wanna miss them. See you soon.